Having a show at both the Walker and a Small View, which is like not opposite ends of the spectrum, but they are massively different spaces.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts?
I mean, I think it's great to be asked to do both, because I guess, it was great to be asked to be in the John Moores, and that's kind of this really lovely surprise, and you kind of get taken on this trip with them, which is just incredible, you know. It's like one piece, and it's kind of a piece that kind of stands for, I guess, what you find was probably the most important thing in your practice at that time when you're entering. But it's been really nice to come here with other works that are kind of leading up to that work, and I can kind of unpack that a little more, which has been really great, you know, having a space to myself. So whilst in the Walker, it seemed to be more about these kind of connections between different paintings picked by the jury, kind of a certain theme running through them, maybe. This has been a place where I can kind of come and, I guess, take ownership, you know, of the relationships between different paintings that I've made.
Have you ever exhibited in Liverpool before this?
No, never. Not at all. Never exhibited in Liverpool.
How are you finding it?
Great. Well, no, it's brilliant. I mean, it's nice to come up, I guess, for the John Moores, which is a nice surprise to be selected, so I've been brought up for that, but through other people who've shown here in a Small View, Claire Dorset in particular, who kind of, you know, put me in touch with Ben and Kelly and opened up this opportunity, so that's something that I wouldn't have expected, but it is really nice that sort of one thing is leading to another. Two very different opportunities, one's where you can really take things apart, I think, kind of play around with the space, and another where you're sort of taken, or your work is kind of taken in with a sort of a theme has been sort of, you know, put together by the judges, so it's, so far it's great.
Just say that.
Why and how did you start this morning?
Basically it came about, Ben and myself both on an MA at Preston University, and one of the modules in the first year was we had to undo a case study,
yeah.
Right? And we thought, right, we'll try and put a space together, which at first was impossible. And then Ben actually came across Goston's building, and he found this space, and we were like, right, we're going for it. And that's literally how it came about. The name wasn't as fancy, was it really? We were sort of just messing around with names. And
originally, we were just going to show it out, like, weren't we? And then we thought,
yeah,
might as well keep it on, because the rent was quite cheap.
Yeah, a year later, still.
Oh, yeah, pretty much, yeah.
How many artists have you had in the space?
It's about 10 now, isn't it? 10?
Yeah, I think Donal might be
10.
11th.
Is he
11th? How have you found working here as they get setting up a gallery?
It was a bit more difficult at first, when we obviously were first set up, because we were around, so no one knew of us. But as the time's gone on, we've got a lot of support, especially from yourselves.
Yeah.
Which we're very grateful of. But yeah, I mean, we do get support, don't we, a lot of people?
I mean, the longer, yeah, we get. Like, we've got regulars almost.
What do you think it is that people are coming from spaces like Fact, New Contemporaries, John Moore's Prize to exhibit in a Small View? What makes a Small View different to the other small spaces?
I think it's because we basically give them the key, yeah.
Yeah, it's more
experimental,
like,
isn't it? You can do what you want.
We've always called it a project space or creative space, because we're never that much involved. Like, we go in and we go, no, that needs to go there, or blah, blah.
Yeah.
We literally give Donal a key and we're like,
do what you want.
Set up the way you want to do it. Yeah, I think that's what maybe makes us different. I mean, I'm not 100% sure how them guys function, but I'm guessing it's not quite as free as that.
Yeah.
Do it.
Yeah, because even in terms of statement and how they write about the way that you write, you want.
Right, can you tell us a bit about your work and your practice?
Yeah. Yeah. So often end up snowballing processes, you know, working between a lot of it ends up painting, you know, but actually I'll end up doing a huge amount of small little maquettes. I'll make little maquettes in the studio, I'll make digital animations, I'll project onto those maquettes, photographs of those kind of meeting points will end up on in a computer. A lot of stuff gets done in Photoshop, but actually a lot of it is sort of image by image, kind of building up the painting. Just it kind of, they kind of grow really, rather than, even though they might have this sort of procedural look to them, they're actually growing image by image. So I might get enough images to start off, but actually sometimes I might need to go back to a sculpture, back to a digital collage that I've made in order to, I guess, try and resolve the painting.
And this is what this is the sort of this amalgamated together and led to that piece of water. As a, not
yes. Yeah, some of the watercolours where I'm just bringing one sort of painted section next to another in a big blank white space, that's the way of trying to work out composition, trying to work out what works well next to another thing. But what I found is I used to do these watercolours as a way of almost like studies, as a kind of a way into the paintings, the acrylic paintings. But I found more and more that actually some of these are becoming more like pieces in their own right. And I've actually been working on watercolours now for about a year full stop, right? Just been the luminosity you get out of watercolour. It's slightly different to acrylics. While it's in acrylics, I'm more interested in these objects that are kind of glistening, glittering, where there's a kind of a mirroring reflection of the objects. I think the way I'm treating light in watercolours is more like there's light emanating from the objects themselves, and that's something I didn't really expect. So I've been kind of running with that now for a while.
Okay. Is there an importance of audience to you, or is it just the painting that you want to sort of stand for itself?
Do you think the audience like plays a part, or is that kind of in my head?
Because obviously you'll have a very different audience here to what you'll have at the Walker.
I guess so. I like the fact that, I guess, in a small gallery like this one, a small view, that people have to kind of, you know, they have to kind of, you know, find where it is and, you know, hunt it out. And then you go down this arcade and it's just this beautiful gleaming white space, you know, this really calm space up on the floor. Whilst, I guess, with the Walker, you're going along and you're actually walking through the galleries, going through a lot of the Victorian art that they have. And it's a different sort of an entry, a different kind of an entry point. You know? I mean, I'm always thinking about what the viewer is picking up from these paintings. You know, I'm not really making them for myself. I'm always thinking about what am I setting up in the paintings for the viewers to orchestrate. So it's kind of putting together just little bits of narrative.